Oh! fight.
Thank you.
fight. fool! waving. He waved the rope. I don't know what the point of that one was.
It's a duplex by one that the way Funk actually almost before. That helped the key and it was awesome. All package.
First round of the NWA World Title Tournament. Again, let's get this back up on Twitter here. Working on getting that up on Twitter here. I appreciate your patience while we five matches down, three more to go this evening. Do the first, half of the tournament. Going to be number 13 seed Rob Conway taking on the number 20 seed Christian Cage in on the next matchup here. Go ahead and go to that one. We're nearing the 1 hour mark of our stream here, so if you are joining us for the first time, thank you for joining us for the first time here. There's the bell, we are underway. I will make an effort to figure out what's going on with the audio setting, try to get that corrected for the next stream. We're too ingrained into it right now. I apologize if you're watching it. Hearing the game over me, that's definitely not my intention with this one. So, Rob Conway, another man a lot of people probably thought was unlikely to be the NWA World Heavyweight Champion. He won the title in Antonio, Texas. With a last-minute substitute for Jack Dane. Defeated the Tokyo Monster Pega to win the belt. Held the belt for 294 days before losing at a record Kingdom 8 for Tokyo Monster Kojima. And then, that is taking where I hated myself for a long time. Hall of Fame Alley Club on June 2nd, 2014. Rob Conway defeated Kojima to win the NWA World Heavyweight Championship. My son was born about 6 weeks before that, about 5 weeks before that show. I am not going to Hall of Fame Alley that year. But I wanted to be around to help my fiance with our son. And missed the world title change. I want to think that for a lot of people, a once-in-a-lifetime type of event. Luckily, they did get another chance to end to be a world title champion perk. And well, actually, in attendance at all in 2018, got to see this Cody Rhodes beat the Galvez. Talk about that a little bit more. Next time on our stream. get the audio agreement. Christian Cage winning the NWA World Title during the TNA era.
One.
Two-time champion defeating Jeff Jarrett and Perfect, the 2000 champion to win the NWA World Title. He would have been TNA a couple months at that point. He had just left the WWE about 3 months prior to that when the contract expired. Christian Cage officially the last NWA World Champion of the TNA era. He defeated Abyss and Sting in a three-way elimination match on January 14, 2007 to win his second world title. Flip of the championship on May 14, 2007. The NWA announced that they were taking control of the belt back in the beginning of the tournament. A lot of controversy surrounding that as well. The day of the TNA Cankerfight pay-per-view in Orlando, Florida, TNA had been told ahead of time that the NWA would take the belt back, that they were going to have that pay-per-view and the TV taping the following night. To figure out how to get the belt off of their men. They had a situation where Kurt Angle won the championship from Christian Cage in a controversial ending, made the belt vacant the next night. But the NWA had already announced the title vacancy and that Christian was not the champion. The NWA does not recognize Kurt Angle as the champion, and recognize Christian Cage as the final NWA champion of that TNA era. And what was frustrating for me as a fan, and I actually bought that Sacrifice pay-per-view for the full reason that I knew it was going to be the last NWA World Title match of the era, and I wanted to have that on tape. And they decided they were going to jump the gun on that decision.
Six, seven, eight.
hooked him with the knee. Man did not qualify for Sherman. Dusty Rhodes, 3 times, he's going to be the champion.
1, 2.
Dusty Rhodes, 3 times, the champion. Not in tournament, so he's 12 days short. Ron Kelly, combined with Ken Guido, Raven, Sonny Hashimoto, the All-Man Machine, Ricky Steamboat, Ron Garvin, Takumi Fujinami, Biff, Cody Rhodes, Brett Huffer, Ken Shamrock, Green Blue, Taboo. Some of them qualify for the tournament. Ryan Baba had 3 title reigns, combining for 19 days. Not to Dave O'Neill, Gary Field, Tommy Ritz, Ron, Shane Douglas, apparently Reagan Hall, we were champion when we were with Wikipedia. Those were all men who had held the NWA World Title Championship. Remember, they did not qualify for the third quarter of the tournament. Richard was on 9. He hit that beautifully. Matthew Curry gets 20 count 1-4. We'll come up to the rear, but it didn't happen. Ended on the low block. That close ending on the low block. Minutes even for that matchup. Okay, I'm gonna stop. I'm gonna stop customizing the results on Twitter here. It's getting a little bit late. Only 2 more matches here tonight in this tournament. I don't expect this one to go very long, but I could be surprised. It's gonna be damn the beef ever. Taking on Satoshi Kojima. Number 5, Keith Sever. Number 28, Keith Kojima. We've talked about Kojima a little bit earlier on here. We'll go ahead and get a little bit more detail with that. With Satoshi Kojima, we mentioned earlier on. Won his one and only NWA World Championship on January 4th, 2014. Two. Two. Record TV in the Tokyo. Two. Maybe the biggest crowd ever seen NWA World Title change. 35,000 people for that particular show. However, Carr, for all the controversy he had, Okada Naito for the heavyweight title he had, Takahashi for the Intercontinental title, banned the guy for that, the Intercontinental title match, the one left that night. Years later, that's still coming up in four Japan Pro. I don't know how long the title lock is on the way. I called my alley bug, I went from there. Dan the Beat Hammer is the guy that was brought in to bring credibility back to the NWA World title after a number of different controversies in the early 90s. WCW on two separate occasions, dropping the NWA belt. Rick Flair with the WCW title, and Flair went to WWF, they were forced to strip Flair of that belt. Second time when they stripped Flair of that belt when they WCW left the NWA in September 93. Winning the tournament in Philadelphia on the 27th. Rick Candido winning the tournament November 19th of 1994 in Cherry Hill, New Jersey, and featuring his mother from the tournament. Show that's available. At least last I checked, was available in its entirety on YouTube. And Dave Gavern for the Smoky Mountain Wrestling card in Kentucky. Beat Rick Candido. Severn coming on to WWF TV in the early 1998 after the world champion, although that didn't last. Anyway. Severn. After 1,500 days over in 1905, regained the championship. March 9th, 2002, defeating Shinya Hashimoto. He's been training for an MMA fight in the formation of TNA. He's the end of the title on the first TNA weekly pay-per-view. Maybe it took him the belt. But Kevin definitely in the mold of what the NWA champion used to be, but the NWA champion used to have. At least have some sort of shooting background. Page, I'm gonna step away from the screen here for a couple of minutes here, so enjoy the match. I'll be back with you as soon as I can. Yeah.
Cup!
Alright, I'm sorry for the
delay there.
Unfortunately, sometimes just can't help it and you gotta walk away from things here. Welcome, Charlie Butter, my co-host on the IWTV Guide podcast. With the NWA tournament, Muta didn't qualify, so not during the NWA portion of the tournament at all. Although, I know he'll be in the... I'm pretty sure he'll be in the IWGP tournament when I get to that point. I feel bad for disappointing you, man. I'm sorry. Trying to take a look at what happened here. Rolling arm lock submission for Dan Severn. Toshi Kojima. 11:46. I do need to play the night, so I don't get interrupted, and I'm getting interrupted anyway. So I'm not really thrilled with that, but it is what it is. And we've got one more match coming up tonight, here in the first round. To finish up the top half of the bracket, Buddy Rogers. Buddy Rogers and Whipper Billy Watson coming up here. Charlie, man, I based the seeding on the length of title reign. Great Muta's title reign was not very long. He beat Chono in 93, only had it for 48 days before he lost about the Muta, before he lost about the Wyndham. And Muta really did not come anywhere close to qualifying. Muta would have been like a 45 feed if it was a 64-man tournament, I'd have gotten him in there, but... Anyway, this is going to be the last match of this particular evening here. Nature Boy Buddy Rogers on the left, Whooper Billy Watson on the right. And I am very curious about how this one goes, because it took me like 45 minutes just to download Buddy Rogers' move sketch. If he loses in the first round, I think I'll cry. I'm not even joking about that. Buddy Rogers winning the championship on June 30th, 1961 from Pat O'Connor, 2 out of 3 falls at Comiskey Park in Chicago. Over 20,000 fans in attendance for that match. It's actually a very good match. It is on YouTube. Yeah, if you feel the urge to check that out. Whipper Billy Watson, we talked about before. We did have a little bonus match with him when we did the 1948 and earlier tournament. We talked about him before.
He defeated Luthez for the championship on March 15th, 1956, a countout victory in Toronto. And then losing it back to Fed also by countout on November 19th, 1956. Figure four leg on, figure four grapevine, whatever you want to call it, for the Nature Boy, Buddy Rogers, wrestling the original Nature Boy. Of course, all the Nature Boy that came after Rogers, clearly patterned themselves after Buddy Rogers. Ric Flair patterned himself after Buddy Rogers. Buddy Landell patterned himself after Buddy Rogers. Paul Lee, think he's Ric Flair. Go. If you know, you know. Roger, going here. Roger, one of those title reigns as well, but all kinds of flipping turns in it. Roger in. A couple of unofficial title watch on the record. November 21st of 1961, Buddy Rogers and Franklin Killer Kowalski at Montreal, 2-3-fall match. Injured in the first fall, broke an ankle actually, missed quite a bit of time. Some places recognized Kowalski as champion, a lot of places didn't. August 2nd, 1952, Rogers wrestled with an injury that lost Buddy Rogers in Toronto to Bruno. Buddy Rogers lost to Bruno Camortino, I'm sorry, in Toronto on August 2nd, wrestled with an injury. That Camortino refusing to accept the championship, the NWA did not consider that a title change as a result. The interesting one, August 18th, 1962, Newark, New Jersey. Bobo Burghill defeats Buddy Rogers. Again, it's an injury. Groin injury in this particular case. Burghill says he definitely wants a championship. But a doctor determined that Rogers had not suffered an injury. And many places ruled that Burghill should have been the NWA World Champion after that match. NWA does not recognize the title reign. Rogers does cover two of those disputes. He defeats Bubba Brazil on October 3rd of 1962 in Toledo, Ohio. He defeats Killer Kowalski at Madison Square Garden on January 21st, 1963. And then, of course, January 24th, 1963. Pretty famous match with Luthez. Luthez wins the belt back from Rogers. Much of the kind of building basically told Buddy Rogers he is not getting his title belt to pocket back unlucky to go through with the match. Zeg winning a one-fall match. Promoters in New York refusing to accept the title change because it was only a one-fall match, not a 2-3-fall match. It led to the formation of the WWWF. And then Fez beat Rogers 2-3-fall 2 weeks later anyway, so the entire reason for this formation of WWF was completely shot. Oof. A lot of times the twists and turns are a lot more interesting than we have to imagine. There's still a part of me that wishes kayfabe was still around, but at the same time you get a story like that, and I really wish there would have been a record for around in 1962, 1963 to go over all of that. We passed the 10-minute mark here again. One fall, 45-minute timer for all these matches. We get the possibility of a timer draw to make it very unlikely, make it very rare. Top half of the first round bracket. Tentative plan for that second half of the bottom half of the bracket is really critical and legal. That's it. God damn you, Buddy Rogers. God damn you. Took longer to fucking download you than it did for you to fucking get away from the tournament. Fuck you, Buddy Rogers.
I'm pretty good about not swearing on this stream. That's about the first time I've dropped an F-bomb, and if you've looked at the IWTV guide, you know I drop F-bombs left and right. Alright, with her belly watch and with the sleeper hold. I expect you to laugh that one up, Butter. Yeah, I know. We talked about it on the podcast, how pissed off I would be if it actually ended up happening, and here we are. Alright, 11:02. It's also the shortest match of the tournament so far. Like, what the hell? Oh, boy. Alright. I think that's going to about wrap it up for tonight. It's almost 11 o'clock. I got to work tomorrow. And I'm not doing 8 more matches tonight. It's just not happening. So, tentatively, Thursday afternoon. Might wait till Thursday evening. We'll have to see. For the rest of the first round, I'm going to go ahead and go over. I got to save this anyway. We'll go over the rest of that bracket real quick before we go off the air here. Okay, turn to progress. So, Harley Rake against Masahiro Chono. Blue Demon Jr. against Tim Storm. Gene Kaniski against Colt Cabana. Jack Briscoe against Sting. National Treasure Nick Aldis versus the King of Old School Steve Corino. That's probably the one match still left in this tournament here that I would love to have seen in real life. Pat O'Connor against AJ Styles. Ric Flair against the Tokyo Monster Kahegas. Naoya Ogawa against Jack Dane. That'll all be coming up the next time we do the stream, which is probably going to be on Thursday. Remember to follow me on Twitter, at RefJayhawk, find out when we go live. Follow my podcast, at IWTV Guide. Listen to IWTV Guide wherever you download your favorite podcast, or through pwponderings.com with Mike Gull and Charlie Butters. Stay safe, wear your mask, Black Lives Matter. Talk to you later, everybody.